I have this inverter mini split control board. I am turning on the electric supply to power the control board. And let's see what happens here. I have turned it on with the remote on heat mode, as the weather is cold. And let's see how it works. And see this. The PCB control board tried to start the compressor 2 times for 2 seconds. But the compressor didn't start. And then the display shows an error. This LED light of the outdoor PCB board has started to blink faster.
11 minutes later.
Now see, the LED light has stopped blinking faster, and the control system of the PCB has got normal. The system tries to start the compressor 5 to 6 times, but when the compressor does not start, the P1 error is shown on display. When I physically see the PCB board of this mini split, it has been damaged. The capacitors in this PCB are blown up badly. And I think they have blown up due to overheating. The plastic cover on top of the capacitors has been busted. So let's change these capacitors and check whether the PCB works fine after replacing these capacitors. Now let's install these new capacitors. These are the same values of the capacitor I had removed before, which are 450 volts and 680 microfarads. I will solder the capacitor now. And now I am soldering the second capacitor. Now I have changed the capacitors, but I will now check the PCB board with the multimeter to confirm something else bad in the PCB or not. The LED light has started to blink. This means the PCB has started to work. Now I am checking the voltages of the IPM. I have attached one probe on the positive and the other on the negative terminal. The multimeter is showing 313 DC volts. Now I am checking the negative and the UVW pins of the IPM. So I am getting 13.83 volts on the W pin. The same volts on the V. The U pin also has the same 13 volts. The high voltages of the IPM seem to be fine. Now I will test the PCB, but before testing the PCB board, I will fit the heat sink back on the PCB board to prevent the IPM from heating. I will apply the heat sink compound on the IPM, the IGBT, and the diode. The benefit of this compound is that it transfers the heat quickly toward the heat sink, which is dissipated from these electronic components. Now I have installed the heat sink back on the board. Now I am again supplying electricity to the PCB board. And let's see whether it works fine or not. The PCB's light is blinking normally. The compressor has started to work. The speed of the compressor has also started increasing. This means the control board has been successfully fixed. So those capacitors made the mess in the PCB. Now I have turned the PCB off. Because it is ready to be given back to the customer, click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch our next videos. and subscribe. It's free. Thank you.